नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम जेवी एंड डॉक्टर रचिज मोहम्मद खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक एग्लूटिनेशन रिएक्शंस. द टॉपिक इज रिलेटेड टू इम्यूनो टेक्नोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट एंड इट बिलोंग्स टू बीटेक एबीटी 12th ट्राइमेस्टर, बीटेक एमटेक एबीटी इंटीग्रेटेड 12th ट्राइमेस्टर. So agglutination reaction, what is the agglutination? Agglutination actually the antigen-antibody reaction which results in the clumping, which results in the formation of clumps. So when an antigen and antibody interact with each other, okay, they are very specific to each other. Okay, when they combine to each other, this combination which is specific which results in the formation of clumps. Okay, and this clumping is between particular antigen and antibody. Okay, and the antibody that causes agglutination is known as the agglutinin, and the particular antigen aggregated are known as agglutinogens. And mostly the agglutination reaction happens in bacteria, viruses, RBC, platelets and lymphocytes. And when the red blood cells are involved in agglutination reactions, then it is known as the hemagglutination of RBC. And when a bacterial cell is agglutinated, then it is not known as the bacterial agglutination. So in the agglutination reaction, what is very important? The first thing that is important is antibody. Okay, we know that there are various types of antibodies which have different size, different shapes. I mean by shape is that they have monomer, dimer. Okay, if they have monomer, dimer, then they have different avidity. Okay, we have already discussed avidity. So when they have different avidity, they have various avidity, then this avidity is very essential for agglutination reaction. As we know that IgM antibody have 5 units, that is pentamer. It is pentamer in its structure. We know that IgM is pentamer. So this pentamer will react to more than 5 and 10. It will bind to more than 5 to 10 antigens. Minimum 5 and maximum 10 antigens will bind to this IgM antibody. So this IgM antibody will have different sites, various sites for various antigens. And when these IgM antibody will bind to antigens, then this binding will causes clumping. Okay, so for the clumping, an antibody must have various different combination sets. Okay, and when the antibody have different combination sets, then combination sets will result in the clumping, and this clumping is known as the agglutination reactions. And what is the agglutination reaction? We know that what is the blood grouping. When we check the blood groups, then it results in the formation of some clumps. Okay, and these clumps are known as the agglutination reactions. Okay, and what is the reason behind this agglutination? Because of the formation of clumping or lattice. Okay, and if we have univalent antibodies, then they cannot clump. Okay, they cannot clump together, and no agglutination reaction will be conducted. So for the conduction of agglutination reaction, antibody must have different way, more than 5 combination sites. Okay. So agglutination test is mainly conducted in blood group detection, RS blood group detection, viral test, and Coombs test. So we here take the examples of ABO blood group. In the ABO blood group, as we know that every person have a particular and blood group. Okay, and if we have suppose I have blood group B, then I will have antigen A, B. Okay, so when I will mix my blood with antisera B, okay, then this will result in the formation of clump, and which will indicate that I have blood group B. And when I have B positive, then if I will drop one drop of my blood in slide, and when I will add anti D anti sera, if the clumping occurs, then I will conclude that I have blood group B positive. So the blood group testing is conducted in slide test, and in the slide test we first add our add the drop blood drops in three drops in a single slide, and when we add anti sera specific for it, if there is an clumping occurs, then it results in the agglutination reaction, which provide as the results that we have a particular kind of blood group. So this is the reaction of the blood group. In this diagram we can understand that if there are one monomer antibody present, then there will be no agglutination. But if there are more than two or five antigenic binding sites, then there are these antibodies will bind to these antigens or blood cells, and this binding will result in the formation of agglutination, and this is the resulting of the formation of clumping, which indicate that agglutination reaction has been completed. So for the agglutination reaction, we can understand the tube agglutination reaction. Okay, for this we can understand this diagram in which we have added a constant amount of antigens. What is our aim? Our aim is to determine the quantity of antibodies. Okay, so for the quantitative analysis of antibodies, first we added a fixed volume of antigen in each tube. Okay, in each tube, suppose we have added 160 microliter. So when we have added 160 microliter in each tube, then we will add antibodies which will be diluted serially. Okay, in the first tube suppose we have added 1000 microliter. In the second tube, suppose we have added 800 microliter. First tube we have added approximately 800 microliter. In the second tube, suppose we have added 600 microliter. In the third tube, suppose we have added 400 microliter. And in this tube, suppose we have added 160 microliter. In the next tube, suppose we have added 120 or so. When the particular concentration of a particular antigen will match together, okay, if we have added a similar amount of antigen or antibody, then they will match together, and we can conduct the quantity, we can calculate the quantity of particular kind of antibodies. Okay, so in this reaction we added fixed volume of antigen, but we added antibodies in serial dilutions and in decreasing order. Okay, we added antibodies in decreasing order, and when we add these antibodies in decreasing order, and when agglutination reaction is occurred in any kind of tube, in any tube, then we can conclude that our antibody concentration is that. Okay, whatever there will be amount, then we can, if any tube that has the agglutination reaction like this, then we conclude that our antibody is in this concentration, or it is in what is the volume of this antibody. So this is mostly used for the quantitative analysis of antigen or antibody. We can also use the passive agglutination test. Suppose that if antigen are not able to bind to antibodies, okay, they do not have more antigenic binding sites, okay, they do not have various antibody binding sites, then we can say that these antigen must be improved, okay, because it has not it has only one or two epitopes, okay. So if we want to add epitopes in a particular antigen, then we must change in the antigen site. Or how we change in the antigen, okay, we change this antigen by adding a carrier particle. So suppose these are the soluble antigens, and when we add this carrier particle in this soluble antigen, it will be a coated particle, it will be a coated antigen having more than five antigenic epitopes, and in a single antigen there is only one epitope. So if we have added carrier particle, then there are five epitopes, okay. So to these epitopes, antibodies will bind efficiently, okay. If antibodies will bind to all the epitopes of these coated particle, then this will result in the agglutination reaction, okay. If it will bind to only single epitope, then it will be a simple antigen antibody reaction. But if these antibodies will bind to more than 2, 3, 5 epitopes, then it will result in the formation of clumping, which results in the agglutination reaction. So our topic is over here. In the upcoming lecture, we will discuss more antigen and antibody reactions.